So you want to move to Atlanta? All right. Well, let me show you some shit that you really want to see. That's the night scene. So we're going to run through downtown area. Then we're going to go through Edgewood. Then we're going to hit Buckhead. And then we're going to come back home. All right. Got my wallet. Got my keys. Put some gas in the car. We good. Let's go.
Damn.
You saw the nightlife, all right? Now, the question is what are you moving to Atlanta for? What is your reason? What is your purpose living in Atlanta? Because I can tell you one thing, if you want to party all day and all night, Atlanta is the shit for that. As you can see, it's clubs, restaurants, you have strip clubs, you have Latino clubs, you have all types of fucking things that's going on at night in Atlanta. But you know what? Is that all that you want to do? Because if that's it, then what the fuck are you going to do for money? What the fuck are you going to do with your life, period? So you mean to tell me that you're coming to Atlanta just to party? No. So the thing of it is that you have to sit back and say to yourself, what is your plan? why are you really so headstrong on coming down here? Because I can tell you, there's already 6 million people in Atlanta, in the metro Atlanta area. And within those 6 million people, it is damn near overcrowded. And it's crazy because Atlanta's getting a bad rap. People say it's gay Atlanta, or homosexuals every fucking where. And I can honestly tell you that I don't see too many homosexuals. I'm not saying that they don't exist, because I've seen a few, but I don't see a lot. That's the truth. And the reality of it is when you talk to the natives, they'll let you know. It wasn't like that back in the days. So therefore, guess what? I'm not trying to be funny, but a couple of homosexuals lived here, and then they were being mistreated in other places, and those homosexuals told other homosexuals that it's okay in Atlanta, and guess what? A whole bunch of motherfuckers flocked here. People talk about the traffic and how bad the traffic is. Well, guess what? You have a highway, 75 and 85, that goes north, south, and people are trying to get to and fro in Atlanta, whether it's their jobs, to their jobs, or home. And it's people that's trying to get to Florida. It's people that's trying to get to Mississippi, Alabama. These two different highways connect to those states. Or they trying to go up, like to Ohio, or South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, D.C., New York. Of course, when you have a shitload of people in one area, and then you have two major highways that's going through a fucking city, it's going to be chaotic. That's how it's going to be. You have a highway that runs around, which is 285, that gets congested as well. Because there's so many people that's here, and there's so many people that's moving here. And it's just that from what I see, people don't truly understand what Atlanta is. If you have fucking money, if you have a plan, you can be successful here. I have talked to several black entrepreneurs here, and they're doing pretty good. I've talked to lawyers. I've talked to doctors. I've talked to them all. And they all say the same fucking thing. As long as you're able to work hard, you can get what you want. But that's just about every fucking where. You understand? People talk about the crime, murder rate, drugs in Atlanta. But motherfuckers act as though where they're from, that these things are not going on. I left Charlotte, North Carolina. And I can tell you the same problems that Atlanta are dealing with are the same problems that Charlotte is dealing with. People talk about unemployment, that you can't get a job in Atlanta. Well, it's simple. If you have an influx of people coming to your fucking city, then everybody's not going to be able to get a job. The jobs are going to be scarce. It's just that plain and simple. But from what I see, when you look at Dunwoody, Sandy Springs, Smyrna, Marietta, Kennesaw, when you look at these, I don't know what you want to call them, little towns, it's like, if you're into construction, you'll never be unemployed, because they're constantly building. Here. Constantly building here. It's not a game. You understand? It just depends on what you're coming here for. You can't come here broken. And what I mean by broken is this. I want to leave my state because things are not working out here for me. My baby daddy ain't treating me right. My family ain't treating me right. I don't like my job. I'm an aspiring rapper. I'm an aspiring singer, actor. And I heard that Atlanta can be good for me. So I'm gonna take my black ass and move from where I'm at to come to Atlanta. Because everything is gonna be alright once I get here. No. The only thing that you're doing is taking your fucked up problems that you have and moving to another city in hopes that things will change. You see, you have high expectations for the city of Atlanta. You expect certain things once you get here. And that's the fucking problem. Most people do. And there are some that are disappointed. And the reason why they are is because it's not what they expected. But the reality of it is you expected a lot from the city, but you didn't expect a lot from yourself. You see, Atlanta is just like anywhere fucking else. There's racism here. There's crime. There's all types of shit here. You have your pros and cons. You are going to deal with the same bullshit that you would deal with wherever you came from. The biggest problem is this. Why are you coming here? And what is your plan? Because I can tell you, the people that come here with a plan, money saved, and have somewhere to live, they do very well. If you ask them about Atlanta, they will say Atlanta is great. But the people that come down here and stay with their cousin, a friend of theirs, they don't have too much money, they brought their children down here, they didn't even come down here with a job, they'll say it's a living fucking hell. So you have to understand, why do you want to come to Atlanta? And do you have a plan? Because it's not a game here. Atlanta has everything that you can ask for. The gates will open up for you if you have the money in order for them to open up for you. If you're broke and you don't have shit, guess what? You'll never see the other side. You'll never see what Atlanta truly has to offer. And to tell you the truth, the crime, the drugs, the traffic, the homosexuality, and all the rest of that shit, it's our fault. It's not the natives' fault. It's our fault. It's people such as myself that come here. And then we are opinionated. Then we want to sit back and say, oh, Atlanta ain't this, Atlanta ain't that. It's superficial, a lot of fake people here, da 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 da. Oh, well, guess what? When you look on the back of the license, when you look on the back of the car and the license plates, you see New York, Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi, Florida, Chicago, California. So who's fake? Who's fake? The only people that are really fake are the ones that are not even from here. Now you got motherfuckers that go out and they party a buckhead and they motherfucking renting motherfucking luxury cars and shit. In reality, they staying in the motherfucking storage shed. Because it's this whole image of who and what you supposed to look a certain way and be a certain way. I don't play no parts of that. I can't afford that shit. I keeps it real. I'm not in the in crowd. And I'm not trying to be. I came here for a motherfucking reason. And I'm going to reach that goal that I set for myself. At the end of the day, know what you're coming here for. Know what you're getting into. Do your fucking homework. Because if you get down here and you don't have any money and you don't have anywhere to stay, it's gonna be a nightmare. And you're gonna wish you kept your black ass at home. Links 2092. Comment, subscribe.